Acuja del Toro. Javier Sicilia, welcome to Democracy Now.
Gracias, muchas gracias. Gracias por recibirme.
Thank you so much for receiving me.
Tell us about the impact of this war on the Mexican people. Si nos puede decir un poco del impacto de la guerra en contra los narcotraficantes en el pueblo de México.
Sí, con mucho gusto. Pues es una guerra absurda, ¿no?
It's an absurd war.
Las drogas no es un asunto de seguridad nacional, es un asunto de salud pública.
Drugs are not a national security issue. They are a health, public health issue.
Y hacerla como seguridad pública, seguridad nacional, y crear una guerra, pues ha llevado a casi 60,000 muertos, 20,000 desaparecidos, no se sabe ni siquiera las cifras.
Turning a health public issue into a national security issue has created a war, an absurd war that has killed many people, like 60,000 dead, and we don't even know how many disappeared people.
250,000 desplazados.
250,000 displaced people.
8,000 huérfanos.
8,000 orphans.
Y un país balcanizado y destrozado.
And a divided country and obliterated.
Y el consumo de droga en Estados Unidos no ha bajado nada.
And the use of drugs, illegal drugs, in the United States has not down in any sense in any way.
Our condolences on the death of your son, Juan Francisco.
Condolencias por la muerte de su...
Tell us what happened to him on March 28th, just about a year ago, 2011.
Cuéntanos qué le pasó a él el 28 de mayo, hace casi un año.
Bueno, una de las estrategias de Felipe Calderón ha sido descabezar a los grandes... capos.
One of the strategies of President Calderón has been to leave the cartels headless.
Lo que ha hecho que nadie controle a los criminales ya, los sicarios.
Which makes that nobody controls the thugs, the people who are left there.
Los sicarios se han apoderado de bares, de restaurantes.
So the thugs, the gangsters, took control over all the bars and restaurants and little shops.
A uno de los amigos de mi hijo, en un bar que había ido la noche anterior, le habían robado sus cámaras, su material de trabajo, era diseñador.
One of my son's friends, he was a designer, and the night before he had been robbed, his work material, his cameras were stolen.
Fueron a ver al gerente al otro día para reclamar ese robo.
So they went to see the manager of the bar the next day to claim about that robbery.
Y lo secuestran.
He was kidnapped.
Y llaman al que controla la zona.
And they call the gangster who controls the area.
Y le dice que los mate porque van a ir a la policía.
And he says, kill them because they would go to the police if you leave them free.
Él le dice que no, que no están para robarle a la gente.
The manager says, no, we are not here to steal people, to rob people.
Entonces el dueño le dice, tengo 300,000 pesos y dos camionetas, te las doy, pero mátalos.
So the owner says, el dueño del lugar, the owner of the place and the zone says, I have $300,000 pesos, Mexican pesos here, and three vans. Take them and but kill them.
Los mata.
And so he kills them.
Y no hay seguridad.
And there is no
¿Dónde
security.
Estaba la policía? ¿Dónde estaba el ejército? ¿Dónde estaba nadie?
Where was the police? Where was the army? Nobody was there.
Hay un 98% de impunidad en México.
In Mexico there is a 98% of impunity.
Lo que quiere decir que si estuviéramos aquí y matáramos a alguien, si esto fuera México, tendríamos el 2% de que nos atraparan.
Which means if we were here, if this was Mexico, we were in Mexico right now, and we killed someone here, the odds of being caught and arrested would be 2%.
Nada.
Nothing.
About a year ago, we had on the show Jorge Castañeda, a former member of the administration of Vicente Fox. And we asked him about the war in Mexico, and he said it was basically the drug war, that it was basically confined to a couple of provinces or states in Mexico. It was not a general problem for the whole country. Tuvimos en nuestro programa Jorge Castañeda de la administración del presidente Fox. Le preguntamos acerca de la guerra en contra de las drogas en México, y él nos dijo que eso era un problema básicamente de dos o tres estados en el norte y no era un problema nacional del país. Su respuesta.
No solo es un problema nacional. El país está balcanizado ya, destrozado, la mayor parte, sino que es un problema también de los norteamericanos.
It's not just a national problem, because our country is completely balkanized, divided, and obliterated, but also it's a problem of the United States for people.
La guerra la crearon los norteamericanos.
The war was created by the United States.
Para proteger a sus adictos.
To protect their addict people.
Nosotros tenemos, y tienen los norteamericanos, la droga es un asunto del mercado y de las libertades. Quien decide drogarse lo hace libremente y se daña a sí mismo. Pero tienen legalizados.
Drug consumption is a health issue and an issue of freedom. The person who decides to consume drugs, to use drugs, it's their decision and they hurt themselves.
We have 1 minute left here on the show. Why are you in the United States?
¿Por qué estás en los Estados Unidos?
Por eso mismo. Porque además las armas, que sí están legalizadas en Estados Unidos, y las armas, a diferencia de la droga, quien las posee mata al prójimo.
I am here because of that, because on top of everything, the guns are legalized in the United States, and who possesses a gun, it's not like consuming drugs. He kills the other person, not just himself.
Esas armas están entrando legalmente para armar al ejército e ilegalmente para armar a los narcotraficantes.
These guns are getting into the country from the United States legally to have the army armed and illegally to have the drug cartels with guns.
Y queremos poner esto en la conciencia de los Estados Unidos y de los gobiernos y de los candidatos a la presidencia.
We want to put this in the consciousness of the United States, the government of the United States, and the candidates to the presidency.
We have to wrap here, but we're going to continue the discussion after the show, and we're going to post it online at democracynow.org. Javier Cecilia, poet, essayist, novelist, journalist in Mexico, leading a caravan of Mexican anti-violence protesters, began speaking out after his 24-year-old son was brutally murdered by drug traffickers in March of 2011, being honored tonight by NACLA, the North American Congress on Latin America.